Brandon D. Daniels, let's get one thing clear. You will not defeat me in the match, meaning you will not out-wrestle me. You will not destroy me in this promo series, or even beat me for that matter, which means you won't out-promo me. And my music bank is bigger than your music bank, so you damn sure ain't about to out-debarge me. Number piece hit ya. I loved it. I'm not gonna lie, it's one of my favorites by you. Let me tell you straight up, bud. There's half of the questions I'm gonna answer now because you're hitting me with two different attacks. But there's some things I want to talk to you about, because it's funny that you're like, oh, you're doing nothing but assassinate my character when all you're trying to do is assassinate my character. That's fine. I understand this, you know, you're a hypocrite. That's how you go. So, here we go. Yes, there are lots of things that I have to be the center of attention of, blah, blah, blah. It's all part of my character. But let's be for real. I would not talk about things that you haven't done for the DMVF because you're the architect of the app and you're trying to get the DMVF out there. And I applaud you for that. But there's just certain things that I do for the Federation that I don't trumpet. There are certain things I do for the Federation that the ungrateful guys like you sometimes try to forget about. And there are some things that guys who they do it and they pay homage and they don't have to. They don't have to. It's fine. Because anything that I do is for you guys. Like, if you feel like you want to hit me with the instant response technique and at the same time act like I didn't, like, kind of jive, like, perfect that joint, it's cool. It's cool. You did it wrong. Like, a lot of people try to do my things, but there are some people who do my shit right. Let's start. Promo school. I did the promo school. Not a lot of people talked about it when I did it. But after I did promo school, promo school mania started running wild all over the DMVF. And it was fine, Brandon. You even did promo school. You don't have to thank me, but you're welcome. I see stars like that I look at and say they're the future. And we'll get to my crown jewel in a second. But there was a moment where I was like, yo, Park is going to be the guy. On top of which, Park was the only person who wasn't afraid of me when I had the Intercontinental title. But those are greatness problems, and we'll talk about those another time. So, I battled with Park. Park proved his mettle to me, and in that stage, on the entire Federation. And that's fine. He doesn't owe me a thank you, and you don't owe me a thank you, because the only reason you get to have a group like Hydra is when you have someone to go up against. And Park was not afraid to go up against. He didn't join to the gang mentality. So y'all get to go against Park, and he's been standing up against you guys. You're welcome. Someone else was not afraid of you guys. You gave a title shot to RB3. Lots of times, people stood back, looked at RB3, and like, hey, it's RB3, whatever. Guys like me and Jason see RB3 and go, yo, we're going to help him. We hit him with the first ever bait and switch promo, a tactic also used by your group Hydra that you don't have to thank me for. You're welcome. We hit him with that, and ever since then, his promos have steadily gotten better. He doesn't owe me a thank you. But Brandon, you're welcome. Kendrick Jones! Oh, everyone bitches about Ken. Like, oh my God, Ken. I hate the way he's doing it. And Brandon D. Daniels, what's your solution to Ken? Quitting a couple of times. What's my solution? Snatching the company out of his hands so that we can enjoy the goodness that we're enjoying. Let's see. Patrick Brandon D. Daniels' title run under Ken, 2.5 hours. Patrick Brandon D. Daniels' title run under the administration that Big Hurt's a part of. You're welcome. Your brother Patrick, he didn't want to. He went kicking and screaming, but I pulled him into a promo series because I knew he could take it. Toughen him up a little bit like any big brother does a little brother. Not you, because only steel sharpens steel. And, you know, y'all was just like, you like plastic sharpening plastic. But I went at Patrick. And look at him now. The tank of Hydra. Scaring people out the Federation. You're welcome, Brandon D. Daniels. Not like you're going to reward him with a title shot or anything, because that would be too difficult now, wouldn't it? Oh, finally, the crown jewel. A guy who didn't learn a lot when he was in the NWO. A guy who didn't learn how to deal with true power when he was in the cabinet. A guy named Brandon D. Daniels, who the Big Hurt looked at this guy and says, this guy, he doesn't see it in him. But I'm gonna get up out of them. So I reached in that pussy, snatched the baby out, held him upside down, spanked him on his ass. I don't need shit from you, motherfucker. And look at you now. You took that lesson, and now you're having a championship run where nobody below that line can exploit you the way I exploited you. Brandon, you are welcome. You don't have to thank me for these things. Now, you have to ask yourself a question. Is the Big Hurt stepping aside because he doesn't have it anymore? Or is the Big Hurt stepping aside because his shadow is blocking out the light for the other superstars to shine? You want to ask and act like I'm stepping back because I'm afraid, or you're like, oh, I'm going to kick the Big Hurt into retirement. But what you don't want is the Big Hurt to turn that light switch on and all of a sudden we got to have a conversation about Brandon D. Daniels in the World Heavyweight title. Brandon, you could have had a great title run. You could have turned title run into whatever you wanted to turn it into. But you had to bite the apple. If you couldn't fuck with me going at a quarter speed, I didn't even have to go at full speed the last time I was against you. And I'm going to answer the question of when I was at full speed last. I'm going to answer that another time. But you know I wasn't at full speed when we each other against last time. Excuse me. And you couldn't fuck with me then. So why would you think that you could fuck with me now? You ungrateful little peasant. You could have taken your title run and spun it into whatever you wanted. But now you have done this. And whatever happens next, it's on you. You made me feel brand new. I sing this. I swear to God, I wasn't going to do it to you. I told Black GOP I won't kill him. But you made it this way. By the way, you said, I know you didn't like the way it ended last time. As selfish as I am, Brandon D. Daniels, the way it ended last time was perfect. I was expecting you to come back and make the promo series more even. I was wrong. But still, I knew you would learn from it. And the way it ended last time, let's see, only you'll get this. It couldn't have ended better if I had written it myself. You ungrateful little peasant.
You want me to win? I'm willing to play whatever you say.
This the way you want it?
If love is dead,
no problem.
Playing your game, baby.
I'll see you soon.
Your game, baby. Just you and me. Playing your game, baby. Your game, baby.